Hi everybody. Today I'm talk about visualization. And as usual, I think many of you know me from the first day, but some of you may not. So for who doesn't know me before, so I'm Michael Mbui. I'm started with PHP Glamstack around 10 years ago. And I like programming.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please.
That's good for
paying attention. The fire alarm has been activated in the building. We are investigating the situation. Please remain calm and stand by for further instruction. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. The fire alarm has been activated in the building. We are investigating the situation. Please remain calm and stand by for further instruction. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. The fire alarm is activated in the building. We are investigating the situation. Please remain calm and stand by for further instruction. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please pay attention. It's too hot here. Download Docker? Have you downloaded Docker?
Not yet.
You should download Docker. Just go to docker.com.
Your attention please.
Docker.com. Docker.
There's been a false alarm. We apologize for any inconvenience caused.
Just download and install in your computer.
Actually, I tried it, but it doesn't work with Windows Core. It only works with version Windows
Core.
Then you can install the toolbox.
We have investigated the situation. There has been a false alarm. We apologize for any inconvenience caused. Thank you.
basically the Docker Toolbox is running a Docker inside a virtual box. Yeah.
Public address system test. This is a functional test of systems operation in the building.
Wi-Fi.
Ah,
give me a second.
Public address system test. This is a functional test.
Do you have a Wi-Fi password?
In the building. Please do not be alarmed.
I don't have it here.
Public address system test. This is a functional test of systems operation in the building.
Just had to see it, guys.
Thank you.
We have some problems installed running Docker on Windows. Service can't start. Have you encountered any problems with that while using it?
Then you can try to install the Docker Toolbox. I think it's easier.
Toolbox?
Yeah. On the website, when you go to the download page, it says download Docker for Windows, but...
Docker Toolbox.
Yeah. So because this architecture may be different, so... We run a virtualization inside another virtualization. Run basically by default it's run inside a virtual box machine. Okay, let's see if it's not. No, just wait for it to be started. Running.
Let's see.
This window 10, right? This looks nice. Okay, can you run the terminal? Still. Good.
So no need to install the box.
Yeah, no need. Everything is running fine now. So we have to stop every half hour.
They said you'll carry on this once up to about.
Okay, so do we need to wait or? Okay.
Sorry about this.
It's okay. Later it's just thinking cut, right?
Huh?
Later it's thinking cut, right?
See what I can do.
Okay. I need some Wi-Fi password. Yeah, I think he's passing. Okay. So let's start again. Okay, so American boy. I'm started with PHP around 12 years ago. Officially working for a company since 2008, around 9 years ago. And I like programming. I like learning new things and I like building things. I like photography, playing chess, traveling, trekking, and I like sports. And I'm father of a lovely daughter. Okay, today, the main topic is virtualization. We have two things about virtualization. One is Vagrant. The other one is Docker. But I think Vagrant is become outdated nowadays. Yeah, Vagrant. And okay, let me. So Vagrant. Vagrant is a tool for you to manage some virtualization machine like VMware or VirtualBox. And it can bootstrap your machine and run some script to do some stuff like install your component, install your software inside the virtual machine for you. So you have everything ready. And of course, if you use Vagrant, you can use Puppet or Chef to do installation for you. Yeah. But running a virtual machine is a bit heavy because like we don't really need everything from the another operating system. So that is Docker come up to solve our problem. It provides us the only package, only library and binary files we need to run our application only. So it's really very lightweight. And there's more things for Docker. Like for example, Docker the concept of microservices architectures. So previously, even for Vagrant or for traditional architecture, they call it monolithic architecture. You have everything installed in one machine or multiple machine, but very hard coded. So you have Nginx to run a web service, or you have a PHP to run your application, and you have MySQL database, and some may have Memcache, Redis. You install everything there, and the configuration is almost hard-coded to your application. By doing like that, it's quite difficult to scale your application. If you want to scale something, you need to scale all the other thing as well. So basically, you can do something. You can use something like load balancing from AWS to auto scale your servers. But like for example, Nginx, Redis doesn't need to be scaled because it can handle a very high load. But for database or for PHP, sometimes the load is not so high. So we only want to scale PHP only. And by doing microservices, we separate this component. We run Nginx in an isolated environment. PHP application in isolated environment. Database, depending on your concept, it can be run in isolated environment or you can run in a server. Redis is also can be running as isolated environment. So if you want to scale your PHP application, you just need to scale that part only. All the other parts can keep as it is. That architecture, they call it microservices architecture. Even more, you can break down your PHP application into even smaller things. Like for example, you have welcome. Okay. For example, you have a ZeroMQ or RabbitMQ to run a message queue. So you have application here and you have a background application running on the background. For example, if you want to process a video or PDF file, it takes very long time. So one user uploaded, we need to tell user that okay, your file is uploaded and we are processing. And the processing time is shouldn't be affected to the user. User should shouldn't have to wait for us, right? So basically what we are doing is like we upload the file and send a message to a background application through the message queue like ZeroMQ or RabbitMQ. And by sending the message, we know that okay, the background application will handle the uploaded file. And we tell user, okay, your file is uploaded already and we are processing in the background and we will inform you when it's done. Yeah. So by separating your application like that, we can use microservices for each component. Like your main application for your message queue service and for the background services. Yeah. So like for example, if you your file uploaded and you send a message to your background, the background collects just code for like video processing. So once video processing, it send another message to another background, and another background will say, okay, I mean send a notification. And notification can be like email notification, SMS notification, or maybe push notification. Is a notification application can be run in a separated service as well. Yeah. So like for example, video processing is very heavy. You can scale only the video processing to like 100 instant instead of one. So you don't have any effect to like email notification or SMS notification or push notification. So Docker, the concept is not new, but Docker is, when Docker is born, it helps us to build that architecture very easily, very convenient. We have a concept of container, and each container will run one service. So from now, when we say that a container, we're thinking about one service. One service can be a consist of multiple container if you want to scale it. Like if you scale a service to 100 instant, we may have 100 containers. Yeah. Yeah. Can you speak louder? It's up to you to run how many machines. It's maybe virtual machine or real machines. So Docker can run in virtual machine or in the real machine. Docker can run in Raspberry Pi as well. So yes, actually it's not running a virtual machine. It's not a virtual machine at all. It's a group of library and binary file. So you, when you work with it, you feel that you're working in a new operating system, but it's not actually a full operating system. Yeah. So
is this ever used in the Docker? Is it ever used in a live environment or something testing?
Now people use Docker in a live in a production environment.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we are moving to a production environment. Sorry? It's not hard to apply Docker to your application. The hardest part is how to break down your application into a small service so you can separate them. Yeah. Once you can do that, you can use Docker very easily, very convenient. Later, I will show you in one application like that. Okay, so any one of you work with Docker before? Okay, so any question for Docker for now? Okay, let's start it with Docker. I will show you a full application first. And we try to practice to build our own Docker service and see how Docker works. And we get to know with some Docker tool to serve some of our purpose. The tool we use today will be Docker Engine, which is a core library for Docker. The second one is the Docker Compose. Docker Compose is orchestration tool built in Docker. Yeah, it will organize your services. And you can check out this source. This is the source code for my talk 2 months ago in PHP group as well. And once we check it out, we can start.
Systems operation in the building. Please do not be alarmed. Thank you. Please do not be alarmed. Thank you.
Yes, correct. And it is, needs some privilege access, so you need to key in your password. I think Michael is looking for the power strip for you. Yeah. Yes. Where is the result of the command?
Yeah, it downloaded a lot of stuff. And then
right.
I stopped my Apache already because I was running it, but it seems that
the open in the port 8000. I'm not sure if anything is running in 8000.
In this case, when doctor is running, then I say I'm also Apache running, but you are very clash.
It's usually if the port is used already, then it will say there's a port conflict, and docker will not run.
Okay.
The latter will not run.
Okay.
we are check out on the code from this repo. Okay, you don't have to run any command on the readme file. Yes, I run and show you first. Second, I will make this one clear for you. Can you see? Okay. So basically, this command lists all the Docker containers running in my machine, and just to show you that nothing is running here. What I'm going to run is, I will run the dev environment. If you see, I will use the Docker Composer file. Let me zoom it. Can you see it now? From the bottom? Okay. So I run the Docker Compose. I will give the file as my dev file. And I name the project as phpsg dev. And then I run it. I bring the map. And I run it at a daemon. After running this one, I expected I can open a website at this address and I can see my application. Sorry. I can see my application now. Now, I try to delete all this service, and I expected my application will be gone.
So the command that you did before started up.
Yes. Yes. I will explain in detail later, but now I bring them down. Okay, it's done. And as you can see here, we don't have any containers, no containers here. And if you go here, I refresh this, it's gone. Now I bring them up again, and I explain you what happening. The first thing you see is create a network. This network is for the container to communicate to each other. This is internal network for this container. And then after create the network, it will create the container for each service. So as you can see here, the number at the end of the container name is a container index for each service. So for example, if the back end, this back end container, if I want to scale this back end container to 100, there will be 100 containers with the suffix like _1, _2, until _100. My application is consists of three services here. The first one is a front end. The front end is running Nginx. Back end is PHP application and a database running MySQL. This container will be run up and running just to import a basic database into a MySQL server, just enough for the application to run. Okay, by the first time when it's run, all of this container will run at almost same time. So my database server is booting up, but this container already started. And because it cannot connect to database server, even through error, it will fail to import database. So by this moment, if I open the website, there will be an error. We don't have a database inside our database MySQL server. Shit. I don't know. Let me check is this one, but this one is the database is still imported already. It's maybe because of the file system is in existing in my host machine. Okay, but forget about the database restore. Let's focus on the three services: database, backend, and frontend. So basically, now if I want to scale my backend to 100 instant, I can scale it very easily. Okay, so the hyphen F is given the Docker Composer files. The Docker Composer file will define all our architecture. I will open the file and show you later. The hyphen P is name your project. Yeah, so this project name is ppsc-dev. And this one will be our prefix for all the container inside this project. So that's why you can see all the container will be started with ppsgdev. This one I just want to differentiate between the project for dev and product or test or something like that. Otherwise, if this one is not given, the folder contains the Docker Composer file will be used as a project name. So it's not look, it doesn't look so nice. So I want to make it nicer. Sorry, can you say again?
I was just trying to see where you got the director, but it's over there.
Yeah. I will explain the content of this file later. Yeah. So as you can see here, the backend will have a file instance. I just scale the number of the backend to 5. So it's created a new Docker containers for the same service. So I expected my application is still running fine. I didn't prepare here, but we can see there are some way we can see the difference in the backend containers. So this is a kind of load balancing. We have 5 backend applications and we have 1 front end only. And front end is running Nginx. It's acting like a very basic load balancer for us. So the one question here is, if all of these containers is in one machine, it doesn't make sense. Right, because what we want to do is we want to run a load balancing in a different machine. So we can do that by using another tool for this one, or you can. I'm not sure if Docker Compose can do that, but have another tool from Docker. It is built in as well, seeing Docker 1.12. They call it Docker Swarm. For Docker Swarm, you can build a cluster of machine, and you can specify this portion of cluster when running database. This portion of Docker can running application, a backend. This portion of the cluster will run front end, for example, like that. And when you scale your service, it's auto launching in your predefined machine only. Yeah. So for example, if you have 5 machine, but you only have a 3 container. So how is organized the container inside the machine? It's based on the strategy you define. So you can define the strategy is like, you can launch at least the less machine the better. So it's put all the container in the minimum machine. But that means is the load is will be high. The other one is you can launch as many machines as possible. So basically the 3 container will run each container on 1 machine. And 2 machine will be free.
So you just have to look at how much resources in each one of the services is going to require and apply them on machines like that.
Yeah. So basically, manually you can do like this. You can keep monitoring the container and see if it consumes how many resources, or you can limit the containers to a certain resource. Like for example, you can limit a container to use only 10% of memory and 10% of CPU. So once it reaches that limit. Then another tool can monitoring that. And one is strict, like 100% of the allocated resource for that container for like 5 minutes. If it automatically launch a new container in that machine or another machine, it's up to you. That tool is very powerful. Swarm, I think Docker Swarm can do that now. Yeah. And the tool I'm just mentioned is Kubernetes. So Kubernetes is still one of the most powerful tools for organize your local service. This.
Public address system test. This is a functional test of systems operation in the building. Please do not be alarmed. Thank you. Public address system test. This is a functional test of systems operation in the building.
Okay, so the Docker Compose here is mostly used for development environment. For production, they will use Docker Swarm or they will use Kubernetes. So now I will scale back this backend to only one containers. As you can see, it's automatically remove all the unnecessary container for us. And if I list the container here, you can see it only have trees. You have power strip for people? Okay. So we have power strip now. So thank you. This is not related to version box. Can I try to restart? I'm not sure, haven't seen this before, but can you click there and go to diners? to install Docker because this
one,
this is not for running the application. This is mainly for use how to use Docker to run the application. Okay, so you can start from here.
My document, I put the document in XAMPP.
Yeah.
So I can, and
then you need to put, you need to change this file to your local hub. This is a part to your Docker.
I need to find this one from
dev. Yeah, but you need to run this one, this is a dev one. But you need to change this docker-compose.dev.jaml to your local. Yes. If you check out my project, this file will be inside my project. Inside here. So you have it running now?
It cannot.
Still cannot.
Yeah, sir. So I try this already. This is wrong. My own Apache and MySQL is not running. So
yes, yeah.
Could there be others? access everything from here?
It shouldn't be, but you can try. I'm not sure. I'm not sure you can find it like this.
Oh, it is not.
What can be the reason? I think it cannot connect to the local. Do you have any firewall? Do you have any firewall installed?
I don't know firewall.
Okay. Maybe you try to restart your computer. Okay. Can you get it running? The port is only allocated, so which command is running?
Just now this
this one, right? Yeah. Okay, because it's 8000 is running. So
yeah, I think because my phone stack is occupied.
Yes. Yeah, so you can run this one. This one will run 8800, it's not 8000. Just give it some time. You get it running?
It's one, right? Lumen?
Yes, it's a Laravel, so basic Laravel application. I use this because many of us get used to Laravel. Then I'll explain, later I'll explain how is Laravel is working.
Yes. Bit late, so I'm trying to catch up. What was the first few instructions?
Okay, you need to install Docker first.
Yeah, it's in.
It's in already, right?
I guess, yeah.
Okay. Ready. Let me check with John.
So I
it's running here. Yeah, it's running.
This.
Okay. This guy also has the same problem. This one is not running. It's just so strange. Let me see. lot of error. No, because it's not empty. It's still there. Yeah, but I'm config in the nginx.config, not inside the folder. No. Yes. Yes. No, that one is managed by the Docker network. Yeah. No, but I think this one, because it cannot access to the Docker container. Yeah.
Do you also have the same issue? Which you did not connect to that port?
No, he cannot connect.
Thank you.
is unfiled. You know, so there's no error at all.
This looks so strange.
Yeah, so it's mostly on Mac issues, right?
No, another people can run. That is one is blue.
He can run. He's
yes.
All also on the back.
Yes.
Your history? How did you do that using search of the history?
Control R.
Control R?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Sorry. Thank you. because there's one guy, there's a guy in blue is working. So okay, HTTP status. It's run already. So, sorry?
Are you supposed to create a database to run migration?
The Docker, the database restore window.
Oh.
Yeah. I miss one thing here. I think so. Do you have Composer installed? Vendor folder is missing, so that's why it calls the PP. Then it's not running properly. I'm trying to see. wait for this to be finished. Just didn't have a problem.
Yes,
right?
I cannot.
Okay.
When I run, I do not follow this command on my phone.
Okay, it's a different. To have a composer installed or it's run already. So so you have a problem with loading the website, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know the problem, right?
Yeah. Do you have a composer installed?
Yeah. Oh, composer.
Yeah, I think it's missing the composer, the vendor. Can you go back to the terminal? Yeah. Yes, let me try. Just to write the composer install. Where is your composer?
Don't know.
Okay, you don't have composer installed? Okay.
I used it last week, so it had to be installed.
Last time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But maybe installed in another folder.
I think it was installed in the local directory.
Yeah.
It's composer.phr, right?
Yes, correct. Composer file. Never mind, we can just run this one again. This one is...
I know where it is.
Okay, then you can...
Where should it be, though?
You can copy it here.
Copied into here?
Yeah.
That's it. Into this project.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. It is.
Apparently, I also see a lot of people might have the same
thing. Okay.
Okay, so we want PHR and we want it into this
yes. Yeah. Okay. Then you go back to. Okay. permission to run. Okay. Good. Yeah. 2 2 1 6. Option. Reply. Group ID equal to 50. UID 1000. Install the TV. Do you have Composer installed? Do you have a Composer? You
yes.
Should have, right? Okay. Let's see this one first. Where is your Composer from? You can just copy to that. No, not on it, Josh. Oh, okay. Oh, then you have
1. Yeah, it's inside the folder already.
But if you don't have here.
Ah, because. Yeah, I do. Yes, that one is in example, and the other one is in C.
Can you copy this to,
this.
To this folder? No, only one.
This one.
Yeah. Okay. Not yes. Okay. No. But your network connection, okay, it's downloading. Wait for this, this one's finished. I think most of you is running the application, right? So now I will explain a bit about the Docker Composer file so we all understand what is happening inside. This one, 2. Yeah, YAML file. So as you can see here, what I'm running is I'm running the docker compose.dev.yaml file. This file is inside my folder phpsg 1606. So this is my folder, and I'm open the docker compose.dev.yaml, and this is the content of this file. So basically what the first thing you can see here, this is version 2. So the format of this file is version 2. Previously it had version 1, quite similar to this one. Actually version 1, is outdated already. So they recommend we use version 2, and we keep following by this one. So the version 1 don't have this version tag. So when you don't see this one, assume that it's version 1. Yeah. And inside this file, I define four services. One is front end, the other one is back end, and then database restore and database. Database restore is only used for purpose of restore data. And I also define a network. This network is local network. I name it phpsg-dev, and I use a bridge in order to connect to the host. Otherwise, it cannot connect to the host machine, so we cannot access from outside. Okay, the first thing I want to talk is about the database container. Okay. The database service, the image name is this one. So where is this name coming from? This coming from this repo, Gigari MariaDB, and the one after the colon is the tag of this repo or this image. You can see this one in the Docker Hub. Docker Hub is similar to GitHub. It's where all the Docker image is hosted.
Docker Hub.
Yeah. Docker Hub is located hubdocker.com. Okay, I need to log in and okay now. No need. So I will copy this one to Docker Hub. Yes, R for repo. And this is the repo of the image. And if you see the tag here, you can see there's one tag named 10.1. So basically, the comment is like you name the version of the software inside this image as the software version. Do you have any question about the repo or image name?
How does this YML file load?
Okay. On of this file, the first thing is looking up for the image is your local. You can build your own image in local. You don't have to publish into the GitHub. But then it's your local, if you don't find the image in your local, it will look up in the hub.
It's automatic?
Yes, automatically.
So how about if I were to put form of report?
I think we have to specify the full hub URL. Yeah. I haven't tried that one, but we can try. Yeah.
You have your own custom registry, your own custom registry of Docker images.
Yeah.
You can configure it to point to that registry itself, the Docker hub. So I have to provide a full path to do it. There's some configuration you need to do that.
Yeah. We haven't tried that before, so we don't know.
we can try and show us how it's done.
Yes, next
yeah.
week.
Yeah.
Let's figure it out together. It's useful when you need when you have like I heard of some companies that actually use that internally. That they want to they have like Docker images that they need to keep it internal as they're private, they have some proprietary stuff inside. So you can set up your own private registry. Like I think Ministry of Education, their team there, they reward Docker instances for their servers, and they have their own internal registry for their own Docker images. It's kind of cool.
So basically, this file, this YML file, specifies all the stuff you need to shove into the Docker.
Yes.
Into that instance or into that container.
Yeah. This is an example for docs for PHP image. As you can see, they have a. I'm zooming. The name is as the name the tag for image as a version of PHP. So this is a common practice. So we need to follow. And also, if you look at the tag name. The listed version will have a major version, will be tagged as a major version as well, all the way until the specific version. So, yeah. And here they specify the CLI command for different between CLI and FPM version. So it's much more clearer for us if you want to use.
Right.
Yeah. I'm so lazy, so I just only put one. I don't have tag like 10 here. Yeah.
It's okay. I'm lazy too.
Okay, so that is meaning of the image here. We specify the image we want to use. Restart always mean once you have any issue inside the container and the container stop, Docker will try to restart it immediately. The network here is I want to use this network. The network name, one of the network name is phcsg-dev. This one is defined below, as you can see here. So that means I want to use the internal network for this scenario. The pause, this means this one is Ethernet port. That means this port can be accessed by when you are inside the container. And this port is public port.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So this port can be used outside of the container. Yeah. I use the same port for our convenience. Okay, later I'm telling something else, but okay, forget. Next. I want to talk about database restore. The image name, almost the same thing. Network, the same. Volumes. Volume is where you define the mapping between the host file system to the internal local file system. So basically here I will copy the DP the SQL to the inside the temp folder of the container. And also copy the my script. This script will run the command to import the database. Also, in order to import the database, I need connect to the database container. That's why I want to link this one with the database container so I can connect them together.
Say that again.
The link, yeah. In order this, when I run this script, yeah, inside this container, right, I have to connect to the database container.
Okay.
So,
that's just linking you to the container that's called database.
Yes. So this one is create the connection between these two containers.
Gotcha.
This
deep. By themselves and doing their own thing.
Yeah. If you have no connection, it don't know where is a database server. The dependence is specifies the start order. So the database container will start first.
And if you have multiple ones, then they would be listed. But in this case,
yes, it's only one. So, database container will start first, and then the database restore container will start after that. Please take note, this one is the start order of containers, not start order of services.
Okay.
So, sorry, I need to get some water. In this case, the database container is booted, but the MySQL service is not ready because it takes some time to start. So some of you, when you first run the Docker compose command, you will see something like home state database is not found. Because when the database restore container is started, it's run this script to try to import the database. But because the MySQL service is not ready by that moment, so it cannot import. And when it fails, it just stops. And by that time, when you open the website, you will see that we don't have database, because the database is not imported yet. That's why when we run a second time, the MySQL service is already. So now it can import. Can you speak a bit louder?
It didn't work for me, so I have to relaunch the command and only the database restore.
Yes, you may have to run the command multiple times.
Yeah.
Yeah, it takes like, as soon as the MySQL service is ready, the next time you run the command is import the database.
Why the depends on option?
Okay. The depend option is just to make sure that this container must be started after the database container. But after it started, it takes some time for the service to be ready. Yeah.
Is there something in your script that tells it to wait till it's ready? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yes. Actually, we can do something like that. But if you look at this one, it's quite simple. I just want to point to import the file only. So I don't have any check to make sure that the service is ready. But I have another file. Okay, here. So this script will loop until the command is running fine. What it do here is it run a quit command in MySQL Server. So the quit, if the quit command is running fine, that means it can connect, and after it can connect, then we actually run the import command.
Okay.
Yeah. So and it sleep around 0.25 second. So it check 4 times per second.
250 milliseconds.
Yeah.
4 times.
We can change this, but this one is quite its own. I haven't updated this one. So you can try another way to do it. In the Docker website, they also mentioned about this issue. Not is the issue, but the okay.
And will you explain us how to debug the
debug, right?
Yeah.
Later I will tell you. Okay. If you go to the Docker Composers link here, when you go to the depends on, they will have a note here, and if you want to control the startup order for the service, you can click on the link and they have some tool like wait for it or dockerize. Yeah. So can use something like this to check. Okay, so that depends on the command I also just mentioned when the Docker is started. This command will be run. And once the command is finished, the Docker will stop. The container will stop. That's why if you go here, if you go to the listing the Docker, this is only list the running containers. So you can see we only have 3 containers running. But you have a flag -A, it will list all the containers. And you will see the restore is running here. Sorry, the restore is created here, but it's not running, it existed already. So after the database imported, this container will exist. So this container is just only happened in the first time only, first run only.
because then the database is already going.
Yeah.
And the other containers that open up, but if you open another container that opens a different database, well, okay.
Yeah. Okay. So here, I have similar thing. Image stack, network stack, restart, volume, expose. Okay. Here we also talk about the pod. But instead of public support to the outside of the container, I just want to specifically say that this service is running on port is in local port 9000, and only internal network can access this port. External network cannot access this one. Because it doesn't make sense to external network to access the PHP FPM port, right? So I don't expose this one. It's not like this. Because this is a dev, so I want to see what is inside my database. So I want to connect from my ID or from my command easily. Sorry?
Is the service use several ports?
Use what?
Several ports, a lot of ports.
Yes.
Auto expose and
port. Yes, you can, if you have many ports, then you can use it here like.
Okay.
Yeah. But the concept of microservices is like, you have run only one service in one container.
Right, okay.
Yeah. And one service is only use only one pod. And all the services should be accessible by TCP/IP layer with IP and pod. Yeah. Though you don't need, you shouldn't requires a file system access in order to use the service. That is mentioned in the 12 factor app. This website is also the best practice to build a website for the cloud to be scalable. All the best practice.
Bad practice, but you want the good ones.
Yeah. So this one is only if you use a cloud service like AWS, you want to build a cluster of services, then you should follow this one. Okay, and finally it's a front-end service. Front-end service is running Nginx. It's also connect to the local network. It's restart if it fails somehow. Okay, I have copied some data to the local and I link this one to backend. So Nginx can send a request to PHP FPM. I also export the port 80 to the public port is 8800.
So 80 is internal and 8800 is
public. Yeah. External port, internal port. And in theory, you can have multiple external port for one internal port like this, but no use. So so any question for the Docker Compose?
What's the common problem that you all have?
Sorry?
There was a common problem
I don't get your question.
The problem that I was having was that I didn't have a bunch of the dependencies installed,
yeah.
So I had to reinstall the Compose.
Yeah,
yeah.
That was what I'm trying to find out. So specifically what happened that resulted in some of us not being able to view the message?
Okay, for our scenario is one of my mistakes, because like this one we don't have a vendor folder. The source folder.
The GitHub that we that we downloaded from them.
Yes. So because the vendor folder is missing, so PHP application is not running properly. So all the requests to PHP application will fail. That's why we can see the website.
So what is this vendor folder?
The vendor folder is all the dependency for the PHP application.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in that case, since we didn't download the dependencies,
No, actually, I just help you to download the dependency by using the PHP Composer. Composer is the dependency management of PHP.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is there any way to specify Composer and start Docker script?
Yes, you can do it, but then your script will be very complex. Yes.
So you cannot just run a shell command.
Yeah. No. It can have.
I guess you could always in the run command you could like composer install %% followed by whatever execution you're running.
Yeah. You can do that. But this one I have a process managers at the back, so we cannot do it. Yeah.
Okay.
We can have another one called, like for example, back-end helper or back-end utility here. Just run once at the beginning to run the Composer's install. Just like importing the database. Yeah. Okay, back to your question. How we access to a containers inside the container to debug? That's a good question.
I think somebody else has that one, I didn't.
Yeah. Like for example, here we have three containers. I want to access one of them. One of the common way to do that is I use the execute command with I for interactive, T for I think terminate after assist, I think so.
Yeah.
And then I copy this one. I specify the container names. We can use a container name or container ID here. Both as okay.
So the cryptic ID, whatever it is.
Yeah. And then the last one is we use the bash command. In this case, it's hash SS. Some another Linux is bash. So we can either try our luck on there. Now we can get inside the container already. And you can see this is look similar like the Linux system.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And then we can go to, like for example here, right? Okay, front end. So in the front end, I map the source folder to var www. So I can go to var www. And this is my source folder.
For Nginx configuration, I map the Nginx configuration in the data folder in the EDC Nginx folder. I can just go. I can just see this file. Here's my Nginx configuration. And this Nginx configuration is mapping to www public folder as a Laravel folder. Okay. Once you finish debugging inside the container, you can exit and go back.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Another comment I want to introduce is also the Docker log. So Docker log, you will see all the log history of the Docker containers. Like for example, you see like I have four requests to this container. This log is outputted from Nginx folder, Nginx service. Now if I reload this one, there should be another two. Yes, so we have six now. Yeah. And we can use the hyphen F to monitoring the log, like what you have in the tail.f in Linux. So here, if I have new requests here, it will come up immediately here. So it can, you can, it help you to keep monitoring what is happening inside by that moment in the real time. So one of the another best practice is you output on the log to standard output of the container, std out. And there will be another log collector will collect on this log and process later. So you don't output the log to the log file as usual. Yeah, it's one of the session inside the 12 factor app as well. Yeah. The buffer? Yeah. I'm going to show you now. Yeah. Yeah. So another one is the start, the Kony Docker start.
Stands.
Yeah. So now you can see the memory, you can see the CPU uses, you can see the network I/O. So it provides you the basic thing. No way, no way. Yeah, it should look better now, right? Right. So yeah, it can see, it provide you a very basic thing for the resource. Yeah. Sorry?
The log messages.
Yeah.
That you mentioned.
Docker
log.
Yeah.
Right? And then he stores the history of the.
The log.
The log, right? Is it in memory?
No, it's not in memory.
Okay.
I think you can say it's in memory of the containers. Yeah. So when the container is restart, the log.
I'm not sure about if it's lost or not. Yeah.
But
I don't think it's lost. I tried, I remember before, it's not lost. Even you restart the container. Yeah. You can try, I'm not sure. Another one is also the PS, top, the local top is similar to PS in Linux. What is the I forget the local container name. Here it lists on the process running inside the local container. Forget about. So these are the main commands, very useful command I often use with Docker. And all the command can be listed here. If you run docker --help, it will list all the command here for you. And then another one I use is a Docker inspect to see what is the configuration, the runtime configuration of the Docker, like IP address or something like that. You can find more from this list. Okay. I think I need around one hour. Yes, okay, we have lunch now, right? Okay, so I think we have a break for lunch first, and then we come back with practice with Docker, and we can.
That was a practice.
We will build our own image. We try to publish this into Hub and to see how it works, what is the workflow, and we will see. Yeah.
Sometimes our theory meets reality.
Okay, so far anybody have a question about Docker combos? Basically understand? Okay, so what I want you to do now is we will start build a Docker image. So this is my example of Docker image. Yeah.
Make your thing a little bit bigger.
Can see? So I introduce about the Docker file first. This is the Docker file metadata of the Docker image. This describes how you will build your Docker image. The first thing you need to have is the base image. When choosing the base image, you have multiple options. The first thing is you can build from scratch, which means you have nothing from nothing at the beginning. The second option is you based on the official Docker image. the official Docker image when started. Sorry. We have underscore instead of any username here. So if you see in the URL, after the R for repo is underscore. That means this official images from the Docker team. The third option is like we base on a user image. Like for example, from here I base on my Gigari user, and the image name is Nginx. The label is also the version name is 1.8. Maintainer is not needed. You can skip it. And from here you can use the instruction. This one, I will copy the data from source folder to var.w folder and copy the Nginx file to the etc Nginx folder. Now, the interesting thing here is this is inherited from the base container. There will be more command here, and one of the most important command is entry point or command. Let me open the Nginx. You see, from here, I have expo instruction. This is my Nginx image. This is basic image from this image. So from here, the expo instruction will automatically inherit it and use here. And this Nginx image is based on my base image. And this is my base image. I mean, if you look at like this, this means it's an official image from Docker team. This Unpy Linux is a very minimum Linux distro. It's only 5 meg instead of few hundred meg like Ubuntu. And it will inherited the entry point here and the command here. Let me introduce a bit about entry point and command. Entry point is the just like the prefix for your command. And all the parameter when you run the Docker will be argument for this command. Yeah. And seen here, we see the command is empty. That means the argument is empty for now. And you can override this command by providing the argument later. Yeah. Let me show you. This image I have in my local for now. I want to run this one. Yeah. Instead of using Docker Compose, I can use Docker Run. Kikari Nginx 1.8. If I don't provide anything here, that means there's no argument for my entry point. But if I put like A, B, C here, all the A, B, C will be argument for my entry point. So the actual, you see the init here, right? The actual command will run for this container will be slash init A, B, C. So the entry point here is to hard code the command you want to run, and later you just need to provide the argument only. Yeah. So if you want to hard code the command, you don't allow user to change the command, use entry point.
Okay.
Yeah. But if you put, instead of using entry point, I use init here. And I run the same command like this. The actual command will run inside the container is just like this. ABC only. So it can override the whole command. Sorry?
It is an executable?
Is it executable?
Yes. Okay. It is the binary file from the S6. S6 is the process manager. It's quite famous in NPy Linux. And it's famous in all the Linux distro as well. It's very lightweight. Okay. So the thing, why we need a process manager? So basically what we want is like when we need to monitor the service. So if service go down, it can automatically restart the service without restart the container. Yeah. No, this is provided by the S6 package.
Okay.
Yeah. You can write your own shell script if you want. Yeah, later I will show you how to write. okay, for example, here, right, I have an Nginx container is running here. I will go inside this container and will kill the Nginx process. Then you will see it's automatically restarted. Okay, you can see the Nginx is running here, right? Worker, and this is master, and even this one is the supervisor of the Nginx. I will kill this process. And you see it's automatically restarted with the new process ID. So by doing like this, we ensure that our service is still running. Yeah, sometimes it's crashed for some reason, but if you have a process managers, it automatically happens to restart the service. Yeah. Yeah. So okay, but this is a bit advanced for the service manager. Now I will write a very simple image. So you write by your own as well, and we also run it.
I don't want you to write yours. There's something on the pizza.
What?
I feel stupider after lunch.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, what I'm going to do here is I create a Docker folder inside the temp folder, and this is completely empty. What I'm doing now is I create a Docker file here to describe how my Docker image will be built, and then we will run it. Okay? Okay, so first thing, I'm going to use the base image. I'm going to use the official PHP image. I'm going to use 5.6 or 7. Okay. Let's see what is 7. Okay.
Where are you putting this file, the file that you're starting right now? Where does it go?
It's stored inside the temp/docker. You can create any empty folder. Yeah, you can create any folder and create a new file called Docker files. Docker file. Yeah. Okay, let me start again. Okay, you see? This folder is empty. Now I create a new file inside this folder called Dockerfile. Dockerfile. Okay. Now we start writing. I specifically put 7.0 here. That means it will use this image. Okay. What I want to do, want to use is I will use this one to I will use the PHP web server. Because PHP now have a web server built-in from PHP 5.4. I will use this to run my script to run our script, and let's see what happened here. Okay, forget about this one. Okay, I need to prepare the index.php first and run on my host machine to see the result. And I will try to build the image using that PHP image, okay? It's very simple, just output a hello world here. The command is running here, php hyphen capital S, and then address is localhost at port, whatever you want, T is to give in the root document. Okay. So, because my index.php is running inside temp and docker, and let's see. Okay, so this one is listening on localhost on port 1234. I open my web browser, open 1234 port, and see, okay, see hello world here. That means it's running file. I will use this file to copy inside the Docker image. I create a Docker file. Okay, I copy the index.php to var.ww folder and then I run it. Okay, I want to run in port 80, right? So because this one is running on port 80, I need to expose port 80. So later we can public port 80 to a host machine, and then we can use this to access it. Okay. Any questions so far? Good. I will save this one. Okay, here we have two things, Docker and index.php. Now, what we are going to do now is we will build image file, Docker image file based on this beyond the file we just described. Docker build. Okay. We use the command Docker build. And best practice is when we run the Docker build, we need to give in a tag, a name and a tag for the image, just like what we have before, like PHP 7.0 or something like that. So I will build here is, this is my username. And then this is my image name, and this is my label, for example. Yeah. And this dot is current folder. Current folder is a scope of the Docker build. And only the file in this scope will be used to build the folder. You cannot use any file outside of this scope. Yeah. Sorry. I need to forget the hyphen T is for tab. You need to specify the hyphen T so to indicate the tag here. Okay, now I'm running it. Okay. Because it haven't seen the PHP 7, so now what it's doing is that it download the PHP 7 from Docker Hub, and you see the file size is very big, few hundred. It just take around few minutes to finish this one, and after this one, okay. You see the first step is running this line. Second one is step two is running this line. Step four is running this line. Step three, step four is running this one. And now it's still running in step one. Okay, step three, step four, it's done. Okay, and as you can see for each step, it have a type like Husky here. This is a intermediate container ID.
Oh, okay.
So for each step, it will build a container. And the next step, it will reuse that container to build a next container. So if something is happened in the middle, the previous container still can be reused later. So no need to rebuild. Yeah. So I will list on the Docker image here, and we can see we have it here. Now we will run it. Current
Docker.
Sorry. We don't have a tag here. My tag is 1.0. So I need to give in the tag here as 1.0. It's running. Okay. It is still running, but I will explain to you why it's happened like this. Because it's running at a foreground, not a background. So the process is just hanging like this. And you can see it's running here. It's already running here. But do you think if we can accept this service? It's running already, we build, right? It's running. How we test it, if this image is running? Fine. Okay. I can tell you there's no way to test for now. Unless we have to go inside the container and do a kern to see. The thing is, the reason is like because we have a post expo here, but we didn't publish it. So it's still usable internally. Yeah. So now what I'm doing is I will kill this container first and stop the container by Ctrl C. Sorry. What the fuck? Why it's not stop?
Do container kill.
Never mind. I can do it here. Docker stop. I can remove it. Sorry. Okay, it's removed and this one should exist. Okay. Now I need to public the port 80 to my host machine. I can do this by hyphen P. And I can specify port 8081123, for example, and I map it to port 80 for internal. Okay. Also, I don't want to run as a foreground as before. I want to run it in background as a daemon. So I have a hyphen D here. It's daemon. Okay, it's running now, and you can see it's running here, and it indicate port 8123 mapping to port 80 here. Sorry. Okay. So now, if I open port 8123, I will expect to see the hello world. No. Oh, that's bad. Let's see. Okay, I can guess the reason is because we are running as a local host here. But this local host is only internal local host, not the host machine local host. So let's try to see how PHP web server is running without the host name. Okay, yeah. On any interface. So what I'm doing is I will change this one to 000. Okay, so because we change a step 4, all these 3 steps before will not be run again. It will just restart from step 3. Yeah. Okay, I'm review it here. You see, step 1, 2, 3 is already done. And it says that it's using catch. That means this container is catching before. Now it's just reuse. Okay, now I need to kill this one first. Okay, this is 3 container we run before. Now we run the container again to see if it works. I hope it works. Yes, finally. That is how we build Docker image, how we run a Docker image. Yeah. So now even we have index speed we find here, but it's not running this index.php anymore. I renamed this one to make sure that it's something else. Just to make sure there's no index file here. Okay? And I still reload this one. So that means the Docker image, the Docker container is really isolated and encapsulated. And you can just use this somewhere else without any related to the local environment. Yeah. Okay. So the thing is, like, another question. Now if I want to change the content, like I want to base on the previous image and continuously develop on top of that, I don't want to rebuild from scratch, right? So how we can do that? Like, for example, I don't want to display hello world. I want to display hello PHP. How we can do that now? Yeah, without the need of the build another image, we still reuse the previous image. Okay, the thing is, like, for example, I edit the index.php file before. I change this one to php. Since the name is stained randomly, right? Now, the first thing, I need to kill this one first, okay? Just to make sure that everything is clean. Okay, now we have only 3 containers. What I'm doing is quite similar to previously, but the difference is I will copy that file, the file I just edited, into the container by using V for volume. This is a file name. I will map it to the www.index.php. By doing like this, the host file will override the container file. And after override it, it will run the same command. Sorry. We at random is not. Give me a second, then we'll create include invalid character for a local. Now I do something like this. I will create a folder called source file. I will move the file into the source file with same name index.php. What I'm doing now is I map the source file into the www folder. Okay, it's here we have a port is already allocated. So that means if we have a conflict in the port is already used, for example, by Apache, this error will be thrown. It's because previously we already have run another container with this port, the same port here, 123. Now I need to remove this container first. Okay. Now I rerun the command. Okay, so this is running already. And now if I reload the web page, I should see the hello PHP. Oh no. Okay. So previously when I make a mistake, previously inside Docker here I call the index file inside the instruction here is copied by file, not copied by folder. Yeah. So when we at the runtime, that one cannot be overwritten. So by switching to copy file by copy folder, later all the file in the folder can be overwritten by the runtime argument. So this is showing why, what is the difference between these two. I need to clean this thing first. Just to make sure this one is clean. So I run the file, the image, weak port 123, and okay, I'm going back to the browser just to make sure that it's gone. Okay, so port 123 is simulate our production environment, and I will use port 124 to simulate our development environment. So in the production environment, I will export the port 80 to port 8123 here. I run it, and we can see from here, its output, hello PHP. Okay. But the thing is, like, in the content of the index PHP here, its output hello world. So that means in the development environment, we already make change to the file, but inside the container, we already have a file. So in the runtime, we can use the host file to override the container files. So we can test our application to see how it changes reflected. So from here, what is different is like, I map a source file into the same part in container, which is var www. And I use a different port here, just to see the difference. Okay, then I run it. On another map parameter is the same. Okay? And then I reload this one. You see it's hello world, which is inside the host machine. So this is demonstrate how you can development with the existing Docker container.
Show it one more time. Do the line entry one more time.
What, this one?
Yeah.
Okay, so the difference here is only this one.
Okay.
Yeah. And okay, let me not this one. So the source file is here. And the source file will contain the index file. Yeah. This index file will override the index file inside the
container.
Yeah.
So you can inject another file into it?
Yes. I can inject another file as well.
Or you can just rebuild the whole thing.
You can rebuild the whole thing, but the thing is, like, if you already have a configuration, you just only change the source code only. So it doesn't make sense to review everything.
Yeah.
And because you want to run it to test it fast, and once it's running fine, then you can review. Yeah. You don't want to make chain every single, you don't want to build every single chain, right?
Yeah.
Okay, can you start writing your own image? Just very simple, just write and make something different content and see how it works. Writing step by step, I will open the Docker container file here for you to see. Yeah. Instead of using PHP 7.0, you can use PHP 5.6, for example, and see how it's running on your local, because later I will tell you how to publish your image. The first thing, prepare your index.php file first. Do whatever you want with that one. Start writing. Start writing.
It's a number too big, man. I'm not sure where to start. What's that?
So this is a Docker file. The name is Docker file. Just look at the bottom left.
That's what it's called, Docker file.
Yes.
Okay.
Docker file is a metadata file to tell Docker to build an image.
But where is this file physically at? I mean, can I open it in PHP Storm and look at it?
Yes, can. You can open with any editor.
It's not this compose file, right?
No, it's not composer.
It's not notebook?
Yeah.
This one?
Yes. Similar to like this.
It's a PHP file.
No. PHP is my suffix to differentiate between Nginx. You can create a Docker file only. You can create right here or you create on your new folder. I create in a new folder just to show you that you can start from scratch. You don't have to rely on anything. Yeah.
I'll do that.
You need Docker. You don't need, you can start from here already. Yeah. So you don't need Docker Compose. Yeah.
PHP version from the Docker hub, and the Docker, and are adding the our local source folder.
The host.
It's a host.
Yeah.
From here to copying here to the image.
Yes, to inside the image. Yeah.
What is the expose 18 and?
Okay, because you see the last command, I run a web server on port 80.
Yeah, right. Okay.
So that's why I need to expose that port 80.
Okay.
Yeah. So later we can use it. If you don't expose, you can. There's no way to accept that port.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. So we are exposing the port and we are utilizing that.
Yes. If my letter in my comment, you see, I public the port 80 to port 8123.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the input and output port actually?
For the port.
Yeah.
Okay. This is the service running inside the container, right?
Yes.
And this one is serving at the port 80. So the outside cannot access this one.
Okay.
Yeah. So there's a Docker need to have a port mapping, or they call it port publishing, and it public port 80 to a certain port outside here. So the port outside here you need to define. If you don't define, if it assign a random port which you don't know advance, so So you need to specify, in my case, if you above, I use port 8.1.2.3. So when you accept 8.1.2.3, Docker will map it to so port 80. Okay. Yes, okay. And the service can serve.
Thank
yeah.
you.
Yeah. The first thing you need to do is write the PHP script first and run the web server with that script to see the result first. Once you finish the result, then you start writing the Docker file.
Yeah.
Okay. What are you doing? Trying to do? Forget about this one. You don't need it. Okay, you start writing a PHP script first. Just gonna create a source folder. Yes. Yeah. Quite similar like this. Yeah. Don't copy. Start writing. Yeah, because if you copy, you don't know anything. Use your PHP official PHP image like this. You can instead of 7.0, you can use 5.6. Just to make sure that your folder is running fine, your script is running fine, right?
Yeah.
By running this S,
mm-hmm.
and you serve it port,
mm-hmm.
for example, like 88.
Okay.
Just to make sure it's not conflict in it. And you need to find the folder.
Oh, yeah, you need a different port here? Because, this is the exposed.
No, this one is only for testing.
Oh, okay.
For testing on your local first. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, you don't have this one. Can you key in the password? Ah, shit, okay, never mind. I know why. At 801.
Okay.
Yeah? Okay, so this one is listening on 8801.
Okay.
So you open the browser and localhost 8801, just to make sure the script is running.
Yeah,
fine.
Right.
Okay, yeah. Okay,
oh,
so.
Sorry, what does it mean by PHP? Is PHP running, but hyphen S and.
S for server.
So, okay.
Yeah, so it's run on a built in web server.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't need Nginx on
okay,
this.
Okay,
yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So, okay. Now you stop it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This one mean.
Hyphen D is a tag and.
That D is for I think for target, I think so.
Okay,
this is
target,
a folder
yeah.
folder where the index.php
yeah.
is
yeah.
located.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, when you have this already, you build the Docker file.
Yeah.
And have you built it?
Yeah, okay.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, so okay, good. Now you need to build.
Mm-hmm.
give me a second. Yeah, I'm showing you now. This one. Okay, but remember to change this one to your the username. This username is Docker Hub username. If you don't have a username in Docker Hub, register one now and use it exactly, because later you need to publish your image into the Docker Hub and username must be matched. You need to log in you need to be able to log into Docker Hub in order to publish your Docker image. For half hour, yeah. Because I think it's for waiting for people.
It's up to people how long it takes for them to finish the stuff. Yeah.
First container running is Hello World.
Okay, good.
So I'm going to run, I'm supposed to run the second, same container with the source change, right?
Yeah.
But do I need to change the Docker file?
No, you don't need. Yeah.
So Docker file will still be the same?
Yes, correct.
Image.php?
No. Same source.
Source?
Yeah. Stain like that.
So we cannot override the files. We can override the folder.
Yes, we can override the file on the runtime.
Okay.
Yeah. So basically, okay. What is this? The thing is like in the development, right? You still using the same file. Source. But you make change here. Like for example. Right. Okay. And while running this one, to specify the source. Okay. To override the current source folder to this part in the runtime. Need to have space here, so just to make it clear.
What is the P?
P for public post.
Public post.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So okay. Python D.
D for daemon. It's running in the background, so you can continue interactive with your in terminal.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay, so by edit and using this one, you override the internal file by the current file, and you can see the change immediately. And because you're still running this port, if you run this one again, it will say that this port is already allocated. So you change to another port, yes, and run it. Now you open.
Why we cannot override the same port file? Cannot.
You cannot override the port.
Oh,
yeah.
Files in that port.
Okay. How did you build the file? You previously you use the index. Okay, that's why. If you use the index, you cannot override. If you use a file, you cannot override the file. You can override the folder, but you cannot override the file.
So I need to rebuild.
Yes, you need to rebuild.
Okay.
So what that means, real world scenario. So I'm just developing a PHP application.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to do the changes in my local.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'm using
You add a new feature, yes?
Yeah, IDE. Just adding some features, new features. How it will be the same way we need to point the source file to destination and we need to compile things again?
Yeah, so that's why I told you that after you make a change, right?
Okay, this is the one first time I'm doing like Docker.
Okay.
Okay.
Are you sure this one you have user there?
Yeah.
Okay. When you run, right?
I don't have a new.
Okay, it's running, right?
Yeah.
So if you open on your one, two, three. What the fuck? Chrome is faster.
Okay.
Okay,
see if it's okay.
Michael, when you finish there, can you put your example back up there of what the Docker file should look like?
Sorry?
Can you put the example of your Docker file back up there?
Okay, sure. Give me a second. Second. Oh, can you see it now?
Yep.
Just four lights.
But there's stuff in the other parts.
Yes. Okay. Let's see, it's up, it's running, is it spot? No, it's still running localhost, you see?
Yeah.
So that's why it cannot be. Now you need to rebuild this. Oh, wait, where did you build this one? Okay, forget it. Docker view.
Oh, I didn't build this.
No, you built it before.
I tried it before, but after killing this one, I didn't build.
Yeah, that's why okay. It's still using the local host.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, what is this one and this one actually?
Sorry?
This one, we are building a new image.
Yes, but this one is running using this image.
Using this image, we are running?
Yes.
Okay.
This one using this image.
Okay.
This one, we will use this image.
Okay. So we don't need to, suppose I'm changing here,
yeah.
We need to build the image again?
Eventually, yes. You still need to build an image, but during the development, you don't have to.
What do you mean by this? Why?
Sorry?
Why like that? Why we no need to?
Because you want to see the chain immediately.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. So only when you see that, okay, your chain is ready to go live, then you your image.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Fine.
See?
Yes.
Okay. Now you make chains. To it, make change to the index.php and yeah.
It seems like I changed the source at a tool at the back.
Okay.
But my second Docker, my same Docker but different port.
Okay.
Do just hello.
Okay. Let me see. After you make a change, have you run the Docker again, or you haven't?
I ran a new Docker.
Okay, you have two here, right? So I need to kill this Docker first. Yes, you can Docker ref to force remove this one. After that, you can rerun it like this. Okay. And you should see the result here. No. But
I think you need to kill these two.
No, you don't have to.
Now it's supposed to be 0.3.
Yeah.
0.3 is 3 years.
Created. No, it's only care about this one. So.
Next.
GPUs is on this one, right? Let me queue on the Docker. So if I run port 123, right? And I don't have this one, right? To see what is the result here. And now if I run with source stay, I see different, right? After you make a change, I think you didn't build it.
Didn't rebuild
the Docker image.
After I make the change to index.php,
yeah,
this one,
you don't need to make change this one. You can override the own one as well. So to consider is okay. Docker image. So basically, you have a 1, 2, 3 here, right? Okay, forget about 1, 2, and 3. Docker. I remove this one first and this one. Okay, now we have only, okay, still have one. Okay, now we only have 0.1. Don't use another text. Okay. And C and Docker view T. My test 0.1. This folder, right? Okay, it's built here. Now it's. Now we run this one, it's 0.1. Okay? 0.1.
Just now you do it's 1.2.
1.2, okay. Yeah? See? Now it's all the latest, right? Okay, so now to make change to here. Right? And you run it as another port here. Using the same image. And you expect this one will be changed.
Change. Number 2 is deleted, right?
Yes, but it's Hello PHP
work.
Not Hello.
Yeah, but for me also it's not changing.
No.
She feel a bit.
That's the same problem.
This one is completely different, right?
So this is completely different. It's supposed to be PHP.
Okay, and use this one. Use this. Same one. Nothing changed, right? Same image, that's 0.1.0. Where the fuck is coming from? Yeah, but the thing is, like, by specify this one, we override that.
Okay, therefore, don't lie. Maybe we can check the whether it is still there or not.
Yes, let me try.
You can check the container.
Yeah.
You can go inside the
didn't have, but how to see?
Yeah.
It's not overwritten. No, but where is this file coming from?
No, it's already we have the source. I mean, so we have synced the index.php to the www already. So what happening is it's not deleting the index.php, but it is copying the source to the www folder. So if index.php is there as it is in the, I think so.
No,
so
I mean by default it should override that.
No, override means see the source folder is a new one for the www, so it is newly creating in the www folder. But www folder already have in the index.php, so the index.php is not deleting. It won't delete because this the source is a new one. We are just putting.
No, when we put in right a new one, it should override the existing.
No, the thing is. Suppose I created one more temp folder.
Yep.
I'm going to put it in the where www means it won't delete the source folder. We just create a new temp folder there.
No, no. It create it override.
See.
Yeah,
maybe we can try that one.
No, like it's really overrided.
So it will whatever we have, we are just putting everything will override here.
All right, but run like
this. Delete this one, then I think.
Yeah, five to 10 minutes. Yeah.
Yeah. But you're free to take a break now. Will you come?
But my call's not.
Okay, fine. Yeah. By right, we should. Okay, I was thinking of starting and stopping at this part of our 3 o'clock. Then we take a 20 minutes break. Okay, we'll come back. We have two more speakers. Hopefully, we'll just do a quick one. There's a little tip jar.
It's not a tip jar, actually.
It's a jar. Anyway. The tip jar, because I'm not having any last piece for this.
Maybe I will debug this one later.
I think I will go and explore it.
Okay, sure. Yeah. But okay. Basically, you can override.
For me, also the same thing. Given the another port, still it is giving the same hello world page.
Pizzas are good. Thank you. Yeah, pizzas are Canadian pizza. Yeah.
So give me a letter. I think it's right now. I'm come back later. So. I still have a debug.
Huh?
I still have a debug session in not finished.
Yeah,
so maybe we can do it later. Yeah, I think it's. Yeah.
I know you're a busy man.
Yeah.
It's a hot topic, right?
Yeah. So.
But anyway, I'm a dumbass.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I've gotten this brand new thing here. I've created a new folder.
Yeah.
And it's called.
Index should be inside the source folder.
It should be inside the source folder.
Index.php.
So you want a source folder too, huh? Okay.
Yeah. Because in the Docker file, you copy the.
SCR, right?
Yeah.
Where'd it go?
Oh no!
Come here. Come on.
La 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 la.
Okay, and now index inside there. Okay.
Yeah.
Now what?
Okay, you build, run the build command.
Run the what?
The build command. Docker build.
I can't do that yet because I.
No, you already have that. I'm show you the build command here. Okay, the view command is there.
What's that?
Docker view.
Yeah, but I haven't finished this one. The command blah 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 blah.
No, you need to view the image first. After you finish this file, then you view, run the view command.
So I need to go into terminal, huh?
Yes, correct.
Okay.
Yeah. After you view image, then you can run the container using the image.
Where's the build command itself?
The first one. Docker view hyphen T and your username, image name.
Docker, not the Docker run.
No, the Docker view. The last one in the top session.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I got an error saying cannot locate specific Docker file.
Are you in the...
Yes. I have Docker file.
No.
This one.
It's a capital Docker. D.
Oh.
And also index should be inside the soft folder.
Gregory.
Inside the
That's soft almost folder. My name, Gregory. But in Singapore they say Gregory instead of Gregory.
Oh, okay. No, but you need to use your username. Because
is that your username?
Because Gregory is my username.
That's yours, huh?
Yeah. Oh, so okay. No, you need to register on Docker Hub first. And this will be your username in Docker Hub.
Okay, followed by what? Followed by PHP.
Yeah, whatever name.
Whatever name I want.
Yes. Just go test.
I can just simply call mine docked up.
Yeah.
Now let's go over here and see.
And label.
I've got one, right?
Yes. That is the name.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Then it's okay. Then you go back to the terminal and you choose a tag name. Like 0.1 or 1.0 or whatever.
And you do that with the colon?
Yeah.
Version 1?
Yeah. Whatever 1.0 or 0.1 is up to you. Yeah. And
this is 0.1 because it's like really new.
Yes, correct. And you specify the scope is current folder.
Yeah, why not?
To specify the scope. You need to pass the scope inside the Docker view.
Okay, so how do I do that?
You already pass it by dot. Dot is current folder.
Okay, let's
yeah,
it.
And just run it.
Oh, yeah, I can.
Sending. Docker file cannot be in. Oh, I gotta save it.
Yeah, you haven't saved it.
Isn't there more to it than this, though?
No, that's not easy enough.
That's enough.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Hey, look at that. It's creating my doc.
Yes.
It's putting it in there so the
PC's not
here. Sorry? Okay, you post it already?
No, I've created a repo, right?
Yeah.
Then after that...
You don't have to create a repo when you do a push, at even push your email. Have you run it on your local?
No, which is why I don't know where to start. Just, let's say for example, I already have my Docker file.
Yeah.
Which is this, correct?
Okay.
And my index.php, which I have not put in anything yet. So the index.
Okay.
Okay.
From as source, you need to publish the files.
Yeah, so.
You need to expose port 80 because you are running on port 80.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. And this is not docker.php. To docker file. Okay. Now you need to build using the first command as the last command in my first part.
Okay.
Docker view.
Which is this one?
No, this is a Docker run.
Okay.
Docker view. My last in the middle of the screen but in the last line of the first
Docker run, is it?
No, Docker view. Below that. Below that is Docker.
Oh, Docker build.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, I've successfully put it inside the Docker.
You don't have to put inside the Docker. This is on still in local, but now you can run the Docker run.
That's this one.
No, the first command is under the Docker PS, right? You see the Docker run.
Oh, the Docker run -v.
Yes, correct. 8.8.1.2.3:80.
This one. Docker
yeah.
run.
Yeah.
What does the V mean?
D for daemon.
V for daemon.
Yeah, so you're running in the background.
I thought D sounds like more for daemon.
Yeah. Yes, correct.
What I have done is I just deleted all the containers here,
yeah.
and I have rebuilt again
yeah.
with the new command.
Yeah.
So if I change the
into yeah.
Okay. So I just need to run this command.
Yeah, correct.
So Docker and
yes, correct, correct.
Okay. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. I run it.
Yeah.
So now it should work, right?
Yeah.
No, this is the old file actually. Why it is
I don't know why it's stored. Let me check it, but I don't know why it's still.
The new file is not at all coming. Somewhere it is coming.
I don't understand why as well. I need to check it. Yeah. But like in my scenario, it's override.
Yeah. You set this file actually. So whatever the source, everything is there. It's like overwriting inside the WWW.
Yes, correct.
Yes,
so whatever inside the soft folder will override the one in WWW folder.
Sorry?
Whatever file in
inside the source
folder will override.
Yeah, yeah,
yes.
Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
But I don't know why it's not working there. Yeah.
So I have.
Why is there a tab here, by the way?
No. Temp is just temp folder.
Because my temp folder is this one, yes, correct. So
yeah.
What do I do? So after I have done, after it's created all this.
Let me see, because okay, I can see why. Because this one needs to be inside the source folder.
Oh, it has to be in the source
yeah.
folder. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like this.
Okay.
Then you can run it.
Is it because in the Docker file I specified that
yes, correct.
It has to be moved to the from
yes.
the source file?
Okay, cannot see. Yeah, it's like this because in the Docker, you see, this is in Docker file you put the source file.
Oh,
it's
okay.
A source folder.
If I want to be in the current directory,
just put dot.
Just put a full stop here.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what are the next after this? After it's published over to yeah.
You need to run it first to make sure that it's working. Yes, okay, Docker run. Because you publish,
yes,
for, yes. D is the daemon.
Uh-huh.
Yes, and then you check this one.
It's kind of like that, only it's yellow.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Which means to say that I basically transferred my file from my local folder to.
No, you transferred file on the build time, not on the runtime.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
if you want to transfer the runtime, that means now you edit the source file index here and.
Change it to work.
Okay, and you run the same thing, but instead of that, you specify the volume.
Okay.
So this overrides the existing, okay. And you choose another port to avoid the conflict.
Okay.
What?
the why it's not override. It's only two. I need to check this. I think many people have the same issue. Yeah.
Oh, that's good. We know it doesn't work.
When I had an error, right?
Yeah.
And actually my index PHP just like that.
Yes, correct.
I did the same error as you did, right? Like, you should be seeing this one, right? But this one is using error.
Yeah, maybe it's different. You need to run a PHP file, not a HTML file. Yeah.
This is a page. Can run HTML?
No, this is a PHP web server. But hey guys, I think our time is finished, so I need to handle the session to another one. If you have any question, feel free to contact me. Because I know this one is very long session, so there's a lot of things you want to know about this one. I will explain more personally. Yeah. So feel free to contact me. I still have one more session, but I don't have enough time for now. So we'll try it on the next chance. So question you already asked, and thank you for listening and spend time. It's very long time with me, and this is my ID. If you cannot find me at Michael Bui, just at 2812 beginning on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, whatever. Yeah, you will find me. Yeah, thank you very much.